TV3. First in news, best in entertainment.
A single hashtag became a movement that has shaken the very foundation of governance.
We are looking for the problems to be resolved. We want water, we want education, we want infrastructure, we want things to work. We don't have to kill, we don't have to destroy, we don't have to bend down in order to have water. And so that is why social movements like ours, it's very important in the space and has to be treated with the dignity and respect.
The impact of a Fix the Country movement has been felt across the country, and after surmounting several roadblocks in their quest to stage a demonstration, they now have their way.
Anybody anywhere who is fighting for the right things to be done in Ghana is one of us. We see them as a fellow.
If they did not seek to suppress like they did, us ending up in the court over 2 months fighting lower courts to the Supreme Court and all of that, we wouldn't have had a situation where today, as we speak, it has spilled over. We are doing it in London. We've already done one in Spain. And now, I mean, something about to happen in Ghana. And even here in Ghana, it is not just going to be Accra. We are doing it here in Accra, and we'll be following up in the other regions.
Leader of Economic Fighters League, Ernesto Yeboa, wants the powers that be to pay attention to their concerns. The movement has birthed other fresh voices who are now leading a charge to fix things.
Fix the country, fix Mother Ghana. You see the power your hashtag can carry, and they are asking you to fix the country, so fix it.
Visiting professor at the University of Ghana and professor of technical and professional communication at the University of Houston downtown, Godwin Agbuka, says the momentum of a movement cannot be broken.
The Fix the Country movement has some genuine non-political or non-partisan component to it that will be able to energize people to come out and then demonstrate. It was wrong to actually use the COVID argument, especially when government officials flouted the same COVID protocols that they talked about. But it looks like they are speaking the right language now. I listened to the information minister talk about the fact the government would like to engage. That is the right of people to demonstrate. That is wonderful.
He expects a peaceful march.
Given what I've heard and I've seen on social media, there will be an outpouring of people on the streets doing what they want to do to be to make their concerns heard to government, you know, officials. So I expect a peaceful demonstration. Of course, as with every event, there might be one or two, but for the most part, it doesn't look as the leaders want to be as overly radical.
Conveners of a march say history would be written after Wednesday's march and hope young people, especially in Accra, would rise to be counted. Komla Adum, TV3 News, Accra.